Hi dears, how are you? Hope you are fine and safe. Today we are going to discuss next unit, the non-farm activities. Non-farm activities. Till now, till the last class we discuss what are the farm activities in Palampur. So today we are going to discuss the non-farm activities in Palampur. Farming as the main production activity in Palampur. Farming is the main production activity in Palampur. We shall now take a look at the non-farm activities in Palampur. Only 25% of people working in Palampur as engaged in activities other than agriculture. So around 75% of the people in Palampur, they belong to farming. They were farmers, they were belonging to farm activities. Only less than 25% of the people, they were engaged in non-farm activities in Palampur. So first non-farm activity, it was dairy farming. It is the another common activities in Palampur. Dairy, after farming, other important or other common activities in Palampur, it was dairy farming. Dairy is a common activity in many families of Palampur. In many families of the Palampur, dairy is a common activities. We discussed the case of Gobind and his three sons. Then that time also we discussed that there was one buffalo. So it was adding their little bit income. So dairy is another activities of the most of the families of Palampur. People feed their buffalo on various kinds of grass and the jowar and bajra that is growing the which season? Rainy season, their calf crops. It was bajra and jowar. So it is used as cattle feed. So farmers, they were feed their cattle or buffaloes in various type of grass, and they were feeding jowar and bajra also. During the rainy season, they were cultivating jowar and bajra. Then the milk is sold in Raikanj. It is a nearby large village. So they were selling the milk. The milk they sold in the nearby village. It was Raikanj. Then two farmers from Shahpur town, they have set up collection cum chilling centers at Raikanj. From where the milk is transported far away towns and cities. So two traders from Shahpur, they set up a collection cum chilling center. Here they set up collection cum chilling centers. Where is in Shahpur town, two traders, they set up a collection cum chilling centers at Raikanj, from where the milk is transported far away town and cities. So dairy is one of the most important activities of the people of Palampur. Most of the families, they were possessing animals, buffalo, then they were feeding different type of grass, and they were giving jowar and bajra also during the rainy season. Their calf crops, it was jowar and bajra, it was feeding to their cattle. Then they were sold this milk into the nearby market. Now 2% they set up collection cum chilling centers. So this milk they could sell different of our towns and cities also. So it's over. This is a simple one. Dairy farming. Then second example of small scale manufacturing in Palampur. Example of small scale manufacturing in Palampur. At present, less than 50 people are engaged in manufacturing in Palampur. Less than 50 people they engaged manufacturing in Palampur. Unlike the manufacturing that take place in big factories in towns and cities, manufacturing in Palampur is involved simple production method. We are taking the case of big factories and shops, or manufacturing takes place in big factories and towns. Unlike these, farmers in Palampur, they involve very simple production method. They used a very simple production method. It's a small scale industries and are done in a small scale. So, not like the big factories in cities and towns. Here, the people, they were engaged in small scale activities. They are carried out mostly at home or in the field with the help of family laborers. And most of the manufacturing, it was done in their house, in their home, or in their field with the help of their family members. So it's not in a big scale. It's a large, small scale manufacturing that is involved they or their family members only. So it's not like in a big factories. So with the help of their family members in their home or in their field, they were cultivating. Example, Mishrilal has purchased a mechanical sugarcane crushing machine run on electricity and has set up on his field. Mishrilal, he purchased a mechanical sugarcane crushing machine. Mechanical sugarcane crushing machine, it was purchased by Mishrilal and it was worked, it was run on electricity and he set up this into his field. Then sugarcane crushing was earlier done with the help of bullocks. Earlier they crushed the sugarcane with the help of bullocks. Now Mishrilal, he purchased a mechanical sugarcane crushing machine and he set up it in his field. So earlier it was done bullocks, now it was working on run on electricity. Then Mishrilal also buy sugar cane from farmers, other farmers, and process into jaggery. Then now he bought, he purchased sugar cane from other farmers also, and he processed or he changed into his jaggery. Then the jaggery is then sold to the traders at Sharpur. Then in all this process, Mishrilal make a small profit. So Mishrilal, he purchased a mechanical sugarcane machine. Earlier, sugarcane crushing, it was done with the help of bullocks. Now he set up this in his field. So crushing, sugarcane crushing, it was very easy than the earlier. Then now people, they were depending Mishrilal. At the same time, Mishrilal also purchased sugarcane from the farmers and he also made it as jaggery and he sold it nearby market or the traders at Sharpur. In this process, Mishrilal make a small profit. So we discuss dairy farming and small scale activities. So it's not a big machine or it's not in a factory. He purchased a small machine and he set up in his field. So now crushing is very easy. So his earnings what increase now. So these are the two activities, non-farm activities in Palampur. First one, dairy. Most of the family, they were possessing buffaloes and they sold this milk. Now in Palampur, two traders, they set up milk collection from chilling centers. So now they could sell their milk in far away places also. Then second one, small scale activities. It was not in a big way, it was in a small way. They done in their home or in their field along with their family members. It's not a big factories or a big business. It's a small scale business. Now he purchased a mechanical sugarcane machine. So sugarcane crushing, it become very easy. Earlier they were depending others for crushing. Now he buys sugarcane from other farmers and he made it as jaggery and he was selling to the nearby towns. and this process he earned a small profit. So two factors is over, and some question is there. What capital did Mishrilal need to set up his jaggery manufacturing unit? Mishrilal, he set up a jaggery jaggery manufacturing unit. So what capital he need to find out the answer. Then second, who provide the labor in this case? Who provide labor in this case? Mishrilal. He set up a jaggery manufacturing unit. So what capital he needed? Then who provide the labor in this case? Who provide labor? Then can you guess why Mishrilal is able to increase his profit? Why he was able to increase his profit? Then could you think of any reason when he might face a loss? Then why does Mishrilal sell his jaggery to the traders in Shahpur and not in his village? So this question answer you have to find out. So this topic is over. Two non-farm activities we discussed, balance we will discuss in next class. I hope you understood the topic. Thank you.